I am continuing with the first problem once again. Till now, in the last, I have completed all the problems in the books of consignor. Now let me teach you in the books of consignee. I taught you the entries. For when the goods are sent, there will be no entry. For expenses made by consignor, no entry in the books of consignee. But the consignee will give the advance to the consignor. When consignee is giving advance to the consignor, what will the consignee write? First, debit the receiver. Who is the receiver? Consignor account it are. Two, whether we are giving in the form of check or bills, we may accept a bill. If you are giving a check, you write what? Consignor account it are to bank. If you are giving a bill, you write what? Consignor account it are to bills payable. These were advance. Advance is given as security to whom? By the consignee to the consignor. Next comes, after receiving the goods, the consignee has to sell the goods. When the consignee sells the goods, he may sell the goods on cash or credit. If he sells the goods on cash, so he is getting the cash, cash account it are to whom? He has to pay consignor, because whatever sales he has made, that amount has to be paid to whom? Consignor. So consignor becomes what? Creditor to us. That's the reason we are creating what? Consignor. The entry is what? Cash account it are to consignor if he sells the goods for cash. If he sells the goods on credit, so he the debtors become, the people who has to give us, they become our debtors. Debtors account it are to consignor. He has to collect the amount from debtors and pay to whom? Consignor. But sometimes if the goods are sold on credit and the customers are not paying the amount, whenever the customers are not paying the amount, we need to check out whether we are paying debtor credit commission or not, whether we are, the consignee is receiving debtor credit commission or not. If the consignee is receiving debtor credit commission, then the consignee has to bear that loss. The entry will be bad debts account it are to debtors. In case the consignee is, we are not paying debtor credit commission, who has to bear the loss? The consignee has to bear the loss. So the entry will be consignor account it are to debtors. Next one, for expenses made by consignee. So whenever the consignee is making the expenses, it will be reimbursed by consignor. So the consignor will become the debtor to us. Consignor account debtor to cash, because we are, the consignor is paying cash, so cash is going out. Why we are debiting consignor? Because consignor becomes our debtor. Next, for commission, this all we are doing only for commission. So commission is an income for us. So commission should be created. What we should debit? Who has to give the commission? Consignor. So consignor becomes the debtor. Consignor to commission. Last one is for settlement. Now, after selling, after paying all the expenses, giving the advance, once the consignee has to give the what? Settlement amount to the consignor. The consignee has to pay the balance amount to the consignor. So for what is the entry? We have to debit what? Consignor, debit the receiver. What is going out? We are giving a check, so to bank, or you may accept a bill, you can write what? To bills payable. Either it can be consignor to bills payable or consignment to bank. So let me teach you the first problem. V of Vikarabad consigned goods valued 50,000 to S of Secunderabad. Now I am writing the journal entries in the books of consignee. So I am right, first I will teach you with the journal entries, then I will teach you the ledger questions. Journal entries in the books of consignee. Who is the consignee here? S. This is the first problem in the books of consignee. When you send the goods, there is no entry in the books of consignee because the ownership is not transferred. And V is paid transport charges. Who is V here? Consignor. Expense made by consignor, the entry in the books of consignee, you know it. But in the books of consignee, there is no entry, leave it off. Now, the consignee has given the advance to consignor. Who is giving the advance? For the security sake, the consignee is giving. Who is the consignee here? S is the consignee. So S is giving advance to the consignor. So who debit the receiver? Who is the receiver? Consignor is the receiver. Who is consignor here? V. V account it are to. We are accepting a bill. The advance is in the form of what? Acceptance of a bill. So consignor account it are to bills payable. The amount is 30,000. The bill was discounted with the bank. Who has got the bill now? The consignor has got the bill. So the consignor is discounting the bill. So no entry in the books of consignee. So leave it off. Next, S and the account sales of consignment stating the entire stock was sold for 72,000. Now sales, who is going to sell the product? Consignee is selling the product to whom? Customers. So when he sells the goods, either in cash, he can sell the goods in cash or credit. Did he mention anything on credit? No, he has not mentioned anything on credit. So we assume the entire sales was in cash. So when you receive the cash, what will write? Cash account data to consignor. Who is the consignor here? V. These were sales made by consignee. What are sales? For 72,000, he has sold the entire stock. Now, consignee also met some expenses. What are the expenses met by consignee? Cartage is rupees 2,000. So when you spend on cartage, what is the entry? All the expenses borne by consignee must be reimbursed by whom? Consignor. So consignor has to give us the amount. So consignor becomes a debtor now. Here is the creditor, because after selling the goods, we have to pay him to consignor. Now consignor will become the debtor to us. Consignor is a debtor because he has to reimburse the expenses. Consignor account debtor to cash. We have paid the expenses amounting to rupees 2,000. These are the expenses met by consignee. Next, commission 3,000. For sales made by the consignee, the consignor has to pay commission. For consignee, it is an expense. For consignee, it is an income. Who has to give this income? Consignor has to give us. So consignor will become the debtor to commission is what income. All income should be credited. What is the amount? 3,000 is the commission. Now, as you know, for the settlement, now after selling the goods, we have to pay to the consignor. How much we need to pay? The balance amount. The consignee has to pay 72,000 to the consignor. After adjustment of expenses and commission and the advance, he pays the balance amount to consignor. But how much he has to pay? For this, we need to open ledger account. Though in the books of consignee, in the books of S, we open consignor account. Who is the consignor here? V. In the books of consignee, that is what, in the books of consignee, we have opened consignor's account. Consignor account. What is the first entry? Consignor account data to bills payable. In the consignor account, what will write? Two bills payable. I hope you all know the ledger's postings, right? Consignor is showing debit balance. In consignor account, come to the debit side and write what? Two bills payable. What is the amount? 30,000. Right, 30,000. This was for advance. Cash account data to consignor. Did we open bills payable account? No, we did not open bills payable account. Leave it off. Cash account data to consignor. So for sales made by consignee, we are receiving cash. Did you open cash account? No. When you have not opened the cash account, leave it off. To consignor. Did we open consignor's account? Yes. Consignor is showing what balance? Credit balance. Come to the credit side and write what? By cash, 72,000. Did we open consignor? Okay. Next, for expenses met by consignor. Consignor account data to cash. In consignor, what we should write? To cash. These were expenses. 2,000. Did you open cash account? No. Consignor account data to commission. Did we open consignor's account? Yes. It is showing what balance? Debit balance. Come to debit side and write what? To commission, 3,000. Did we open commission account? No. So after writing all the entries, check it out, which side is more credit side? The consignee has to pay 72,000 to the consignor, and he has to get 5,000 from whom? Consignee, after adjusting what? 30,000. 72 minus 30, 42, 42 minus 2, 40, 40 minus 3, 37. So what we should write? To bank, this for settlement. The entry is what? Consignor account data to bank.